Hello everyone, today we'll be talking about how to set up Turnagy 9X to work with DJI Naza and how to set up DJI Naza to work on hexacopters and quadcopters. What we'll need today is our Turnagy radio, Turnagy 9X receiver, 8-channel receiver. I have avionics brand, but this is the same as the one that comes with Turnagy 9X. Our DJI Naza controller, serve extension wires that come with DJI Naza, and the versatility unit from the DJI Naza package. First, we'll set up our transmitter. Go to the settings, system settings, and choose the slot you want to use. After that, go to type select and choose Heli and Heli 1. Then go to stick set and select mode 2. It asks for throttle reverse, press exit to say no. So we're done with system settings. Go to function settings. Select reverse and choose reverse pitch. Go to pitch and use minus and confirm it with a tap of the menu button. I reversed the pitch channel in order to make it simpler to set up the mode switch for DJI Naza. After that, go down to auxiliary channels, aux channels, select it, and go down to channel 7 and choose pitch trim. Go down to channel 8 and choose hover pitch. Push menu to confirm. If you want to use dual rates and expos, go down to DR exp menu, push menu. Choose the channel you want to set up, and you can set up dual rates and expo values for the off and on states of the switch. I usually set up 100% dual rate and 0 expo for off, 60 expo for the on state of the switch. I don't recommend to use dual rates at all because DJI Naza depends on having full throw in order to switch off and on the motors. So I'd leave dual rates at 100 in both states. After that, push exit, and basically the radio setup is done. Before you can start setting up your Naza using your PC, you'll have to connect Naza to the receiver and the versatility unit to the Naza. The versatility unit connects using two cables. The 4-wire cable goes to the LED input on the Naza, and the 3-wire cable goes to the X3 port on the Naza. Then you'll have to connect servo extension wires from the receiver to the Naza. Channel 1 goes into ailerons, channel 2 goes into E-elevator, channel 3 goes into throttle, channel 4 goes into air-rudder, channel 6 goes into U, which stands for flight mode. Channel 7 goes into X input, which will control the gimbal pitch or which will set remote gains for the Naza. And channel 8 goes into X2, which will be the second remote gain for the Naza. Now that we have our receiver connected to the Naza and to the versatility unit, it's time to power up the Naza and connect it to the PC for setting up. Naza flashes when it powers up, and when it starts flashing orange, it's time to connect it to the PC. When the light on the versatility unit turns green, it's time to open the Naza Assistant software. The software loads. After that, we have the screen where we set our mounting options. You have to mount your Naza unit in the center of gravity of your quadcopter or hexacopter. In case you have a GPS unit that is coming soon, you'll have to enter its relative position to the center of gravity. Then on the next page, we have a motor mixer. Choose the type of the aircraft you'll be using, quadcopter, hexacopter, and hexacopters and quadcopters with different motor configuration. Then we have motor idle speed control. I haven't tested it yet, and I will recommend it using at the recommend settings. Then we have transmitter calibration. This is very important. First, choose the traditional receiver type. D-bus is for FUTEB receivers. Then go to cutoff types, use intelligent. It means that the motors will start and stop only if you make a command with both sticks to the bottom left. Immediate mode is dangerous because the motors of your quadrotor or hexacopter will turn off in case you just get your throttle below 10%, which is dangerous. Next we have command stick calibration. Check the descriptions on the right and make sure that when you throttle up, the slider goes right. When you use right rudder, the slider goes right. When you use up elevator, the slider goes right. And when you use right ailerons, the slider goes right. In case this is different, check reverse or normal in order to make it correct. Then click start calibration and move your sticks on the radio in circles several times. After you are done, click finish calibration. In case three of the sliders are not green, repeat the calibration process. When you are done with calibration, three of the sliders, rudder, elevator and ailerons, should be green, indicating that they are in neutral position. Then you have stick monitors. They are assigned to port 1 and port 2 on the top left of our radio. They will be used to control the gimbal if you want to install it, or adjust remote gain for setting up the NASA. Here you have control mode switch slider. In this section you will have to adjust your radio so that to change the control modes of your NASA. It has GPS mode that works in case you have a GPS add-on for your NASA failsafe, which will land your NASA immediately. Attitude mode, which is the usual mode you fly in, and manual mode, in which your NASA will control the same way as a four-channel helicopter. I have my NASA set up so that the top position of the three-way switch is the attitude mode, the middle position is manual mode, and down position is failsafe mode. The way you set up your radio for these corresponding settings is going into settings, function settings, bit curve, and for every position of the three-way switch, up, middle and down, you'll have to enter the same values in all three points, low, 1, 2, 3 and high. They will be equal, and you should adjust them so that the slider in the control mode switch window of the NASA software slides to the desired mode. For example, in the attitude mode in the NASA control software, you'll have to set up your radio for 50% pitch curve in all the points. In middle mode, which I set up as manual mode, it will be 89.5% for all points, and in down position, which I set as failsafe, it will be 32%. Next page in the software is autopilot. Here you will have to adjust your gains for the NASA so that your quadcopter or hexacopter flies perfectly. I will start with the values that you can see on the screen: 140%, 140%, 120%, 130%, 120 and 120. A very nice feature that you can set remote gain for up to two channels at the time. For example, I want to change pitch gain, I assign it to X1, and roll gain, I can assign it to X2. And this way I can use my knobs, you can see it here, to adjust the gains on the fly so that you won't have to land your quadcopter or hexacopter in order to adjust your gains. This is a very neat feature. Next page is gimbal control. switch it off in case you don't have a gimbal, switch it on if you have a gimbal. Here you'll have to adjust max travel for your servers on pitch and roll axis. Also adjust the center. The values in the max and minimum windows should be lower than 1000. Next, here is the gain for pitch and roll stabilization, also the reverse and normal directions. Adjust this gain so that when you tilt your quadcopter or hexacopter, the gimbal follows the same amount and compensate correctly. Next, there is manual control speed. 100 is immediate response to the X1 channel of your radio, which will immediately turn your gimbal up and down. I like to leave it at 30%, which is somewhat slower and is more fluid. And finally, there is voltage monitor. Here you can calibrate your voltage. Click it calibrate, and in case you have a very good multimeter, you can enter correct value for the battery voltage. Usually it is pretty good. Choose the battery type, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 cell LiPo. And next, here are first and second level protections. You can set it up like me at 10 volts and 9.7 volts, or read the description to the right that shows how to set them up correctly for your aircraft. After your battery hits the first level protection voltage, your NASA versatility unit starts to flash very brightly, and after it hits the second level protection voltage, your NASA will automatically level and start to descend as if you hit the field safe switch. Now I've covered all the setup process of your DJI NASA controller. You'll have to click right so that to save the settings to the NASA control unit. Also, you can click export so that you can save all the settings on your computer for future recovery or in case you mess something up terribly. Please subscribe to my channel and I will see you guys next time.